So, good morning, good afternoon. Today, we are starting with the controversial questions in and picture MCQs in psychiatry. Psychiatry is a topic. We know everywhere in a medical science there is a topic where we have the controversial questions and the picture MCQs. Picture MCQs are usually less in psychiatry, but still the examiner become innovative and they did the questions for us. Now, the first question The first question is the So, we start with the our dictum for the this NEET PG that let's crack it and the first MCQ we learn is the So first question is this. identify the syndrome in the picture. This syndrome in this picture is the syndrome in the picture is the Frigoli's syndrome. We know it's a delusion of mental double. There is something in psychiatry called as the Capgras syndrome, which is a delusion of doubles or duplicate. Somebody may say, Dr. Saab, he is not my brother, he is a duplicate of my brother. He is not a brother, he is a duplicate of my brother. Physically double, we have seen in the movie cinema, Sita Gita, Ram Sham, it's a physical double. Okay. So that's a Capgras syndrome. Frigoli syndrome is delusion of a mental double. Now somebody may tell you that, Dr. Saab, you know the beggar who comes outside the colony every day. The beggar who comes outside the colony every day actually is not a beggar. Actually is a my boss only who make up like a beggar to keep a watch on me. The cobbler who comes and sits outside the colony every Sunday actually is not a cobbler. He is my office boss only who make up like a cobbler to keep a watch on me. And so sometime he come like a cobbler, sometime he come like a sadhu, sometime he come like a beggar, but I recognize him. He is my boss only who comes in disguise to keep a watch on me. It's a Frigoli's syndrome, delusion of mental double. Okay. So that's a, so he keep on changing his pictures. That's a Frigoli's syndrome. Next in this is a, this card is a Rorschach card. This card we know is a, we know Rorschach card we know in Rorschach card, the ambiguous, it's also been called as ink blot test. In this, the ambiguous forms have been shown. Ambiguous forms has been shown and person is asked to make a story. What actually is seeing in that? It's a most projective, it's a most projective test. We know, we say that it's a one type of a projective test, but it's a most projective test because it's basically about the nobody can predict. See the card. Nobody can, you know, nothing is sure. It's basically the card has been shown. This card is shown in the Rorschach test. It's in the So it's a Rorschach. So answer is the Rorschach test. Okay. Now basically next card is of a TAT card. This is a TAT card. During the psychological evaluation, we know he is asked to make a story about the card. What is actually happening in the picture? What will happen before the picture? And what will happen after the picture? That's a TAT. It's a TAT. Okay. So this is the test for the TAT. Okay. Now I think it's done. So during the psychological evaluation, person has been shown this picture and the answer is the TAT. In we know it's a test for the psychiatric diagnosis. It's also one of the projective tests for personality. We have learned the most projective is the Rorschach test. It's a most projective test. Okay. Then we have this picture. This picture common is the, so it's a case of a trichotillomania. And this is a skin excoriation syndrome. We know as per DSM-5, the OCD is a big man. Include the obsessive compulsive disorder. Like washing hand, checking locks again and again, and so on. It also includes the compulsive hoarding. I keep on hoarding things. Compulsive hoarding. My house become a clutter. The reason for hoarding, they say, is that it's basically the some emotional attachment and something of the future use. So the reason is that I have collected my love letters of fourth class, first love letter of fourth class, fifth class, chocolate wrapper of sixth class, teddy bear of seventh class. My house become a clutter. My wife has left me saying that you better live with the love letters only. I am going. So thumb sings of a emotional significance. Sorry, not its word is the significance. Something is of a emotional significance. And I keep on collecting the 10 tube lights, 10 minimally filled Colgate tubes and things like that, so that once I go for vacation, I will use that. Okay. Okay, now that's a so now we come to the that's good so we now come to the picture. Now, other MCQs are, so three picture MCQs we have done, that is the commonly asked MCQs we have, and now we have this question. Husband is crying, distress, not able to sleep, not going to the work, not taking food, and lost around 10 kilos of weight in last one month, and saying to the God, please take me away, I should be dead in place of her, or we both should have died together. We know it's a case of a uncomplicated bereavement. Now that's generated talk about we know that for depression, you will be saying, Dr. Sahib, you told us 2 plus 3 is depression. 2 major symptoms, 5 subsidiary symptoms for 14 days is depression. But in this condition, after death of a wife, husband is crying, distress, not able to sleep, not going to the work, and not taking food, and lost 10 kgs of weight in last 1 month. So this all actually is across the boundary of 2 plus 3 for 14 days. But the answer is uncomplicated bereavement, because we know for depression is a point to be learned in the complicated grief. And the one complication we say is the depression. So I say to the God, better you kill me. That is not depression, that is a grief. But somebody making a active attempt of suicide. Somebody trying actively to go with him or her indicate the depression. Somebody excessively guilty. Oh, it is because, see, we all feel guilt People normally feel guilt after death of a loved one, but somebody excessively guilty about death of a loved one indicate the depression. Somebody displaying a anniversary reaction indicate a depression. Any emotional outburst on the anniversary day is a anniversary reaction. Now, just example to appreciate. Now, somebody would say that, you know, it's 1 year now, everything's held up. Now it's my time to come with you. Same day, same way, same place, I go and kill myself. It's a anniversary reaction. Next, we have the anniversary reaction. Or somebody, any grief lasting for more than 1 year has been called as the depression. And last is the mummification. Mummification means freezing the belonging of a loved one. So freeze the belonging. Okay. Family believe it's a love, but as per psychiatry, we say it's a case of a depression. Now, but as per DSM-5, we know pathological grief is any grief lasting for more than 6 months has been called as the pathological grief. Now, as per DSM-5, they say any grief lasting for more than 1 year will be called as the hypertrophied grief reaction. Any grief lasting for more than 1 year will be called as the. So in grief, we have now three things. Grief normal till 3 months, prolonged after 6 months, and after 1 year of the grief remains, it's a hypertrophied grief. Next is the forced thinking. We know it's a psychological aura. Before the epilepsy, I have the symptom. The psychological symptom before the epilepsy, which is improved by the onset of a seizure, is basically the forced thinking. It's a psychological aura. We know in medicine, we have something in medicine called as automatism, which is nothing but the motor aura. Okay. Chewing of the mouth, blinking of the eyes, that is what has been called as the motor aura. Okay. Now, there could be a new MCQ, that is the forced normalization. Forced normalization. It's basically the onset of psychosis after control of intractable epilepsy, or it's another name for the post-ictal psychosis. So in AIMS, we know we have a habit that the question will be asked next, but so first they ask you in AIMS the forced thinking. It is nothing but the psychological aura. And now there is a chance that they may go for something in psychiatry called as forced normalization, which is onset of psychosis after control of a intractable epilepsy. So it's another name for the technical name for the post-ictal psychosis. Now this question, the answer is, some people say it's a third person hallucination is a most characteristic auditory hallucination of schizophrenia. So they say the answer can be schizophrenia. They may doubt if it is 1 month, but they say, even I tell you, even if it is 6 months, the answer is cortical dementia. Because we know psychiatry diagnosis is nothing but the cluster of symptom making syndromal diagnosis. Second diagnosis is syndromal diagnosis. So merely by third person, nobody can be schizophrenia. We know it's a prosopagnosia, memory loss, and score less than 24. We know anybody with the prosopagnosia, memory loss, and a score less than 24 is cortical dementia. Okay. So that's a tricky MCQ often missed in the exam because of a third person hallucination, because we know it's a first rank symptom of schizophrenia. That means it's a hallmark of schizophrenia. It's a high chance of schizophrenia, but not the sure shot of schizophrenia. We have to see the background. In the background, there is a old man with prosopagnosia. The answer would be cortical dementia. This we have learned. Now, answer was the dissociative fugue. We know it's a stressful event, fight with the wife, plus loss of a memory, plus travel to the uncommon place. Travel to the uncommon place. So we know they are the special type of dissociative disorder, but as per DSM-5, we know answer was this, but now this term has been abolished. We have dissociative amnesia. Without fugue symptom. Dissociative amnesia with fugue symptom. So answer today is the dissociative amnesia with fugue symptom. So as per DSM-5, this term has been abolished. So answer was dissociative fugue, but nowadays answer is dissociative amnesia with fugue symptom. Now we know MR child, they learn by the token economy. Self-instruction is using the addiction. I instruct myself. MR is a mentally retarded children. And we know as per DSM-5, it is now been called as intellectual disability. That's also an MCQ names and NEET, that as per DSM-5, the mental retardation term has been replaced by intellectual disability. I write it here. It's an intellectual disability as per DSM-5. See, cognitive remediation or cognitive reconstruction are nothing but the rehabilitation therapy done after head injury or so. CBT, we all know it's a cognitive behavior therapy. Okay. For this, the cognition has to be intact, and this therapy aims at correcting the faulty ideas and beliefs. Token economy, we know it's a very simple. My behavior of going to the ice cream parlor is contingent on the fact that I brushed 10 times in a week. So it's a token economy. Contingency management is the best way of treating the MR child for the skills. We know synesthesia is another name for the reflex hallucination, and we know they are being found in the cannabis and LSD. More in the LSD. We remember after taking cannabis, the colors are being heard and the music is being seen. Rango ka sunai dena, music ka dikhai dena, it is nothing but the example of synesthesia or reflex hallucination. It's a stimulus in one modality, causes hallucination in the other modality. Whenever I see red color, I hear human voice. In functional, it is the same modality. I hear human voice, I hear the temple bell ringing up, and I hear human voice. That's a functional hallucination. But here it's a reflex hallucination, and it is found in cannabis and LSD. Colors are being heard and the music is being seen. We know it's a de Clerambault syndrome. Female believing that Salman Khan loves me. It's a delusion of love. What has been called as erratomania. Othello syndrome, we know it's a delusion of infidelity. Delusion of infidelity, or what has been called as morbid jealousy. Megalomania means delusion of being very big, self big, too much they think. Yeah, the most common psychiatric illness with the stroke is depression. With HIV, with cancer, in India, in world, and the most common cause of disability adjusted life year is now depression. So one name, 6 MCQ. The most common psychiatric illness after stroke, after cancer, after this is a depression, and the most common cause of disability is also now depression. Same answer, sorry. Now it's a case of a delirium. We know it's a acute confusional state. The hallmark is disorientation. Some guides say it's a psychosis. Some people believe it's a postictal psychosis. But we know for psychosis, orientation is usually intact. Orientation is usually intact. Okay. So it's a disorientation along with the visual hallucination, which are usually Lilliputian. There is a transient delusion. And in this, by any cause we have a diffuse EEG slowing. And treatment is treat the cause. Whatever is the cause, you just treat the cause. Here the cause is epileptic fit. Just treat that. So we have learned the same thing, that psychosis has all except the delirium. And we have a question that delirium differs from dementia in in disorientation. That's a conceptual question from psychiatry. That psychosis, we have all accepted the disorientation. I hear voices. I suspect people in the clear sensory. And we know that's a dependence. We know withdrawal, craving, tolerance, compulsive use, and taking despite harm. And lack of alternate pleasure. It's basically nothing but the overall involvement in having and seeking the drug use. So that's a dependence. And for the opioid worldwide, we use the maintenance, we use the methadone. Naltrexone, we know, is a drug of relapse prevention. And disulfiram is a anti-abuse drug for alcohol. Okay. In India, we use the buprenorphine for the maintenance of the opioid. Somebody who can't leave opioid, taking opioid for longer time, we may use the drug like this. Alcoholic paranoia, we know we have a transient delusion because they are secondary to auditory hallucination. Some guides say there is a fixed delusion. But we have everything in fact. We have hallucination, we have agitation. But paranoia means delusion. So delusion is transient. My delusion in alcoholic paranoia keep on changing because they are secondary to the auditory hallucination. Okay. Now that's a question of delirium tremens. We know in delirium tremens, when the liver function is not available, we have to go for a lorazepam plus thiamine supplement. And in delirium tremens is found in alcohol withdrawal. Happens after 48 to 72 hours of alcohol withdrawal. Okay, and in this we have delirium plus tremor plus autonomic hyperactivity. In fact, there is a EEG, pulse is high, BP is high, autonomic hyperactivity. EEG fast. We have learned that in the delirium we have a diffuse EEG slowing, but where we have a EEG fast. That's a case of a acute psychosis. Some guides say it's a delirium because of the fever. Has fever since 2 days. See, fever is not a problem, but there is a hearing of voices, there is aggressive, and you know, so it's an acute psychosis. Okay, we know, we have a latest question. It could have a abrupt onset or acute onset. It is not a delirium because of the there is no disorientation. And appropriate onset is onset within 2 days, and it is onset within 2 weeks. That's a trickiest MCQ, that acute onset in acute psychosis is. We know acute psychosis is anything less than 1 month or 4 week. So acute onset is onset within 2 weeks, and abrupt onset is within 2 days. So lot more we have to teach you and give you with this NEET. Let's crack it by joining the Unacademy and making it as simple as be interactive, ask question live, and do the wonders in the exam. And keep in mind always, we can always crack it. So let's crack it. We'll discuss more question next time. All the best. Good luck. Thank you.